Hello everyone. So as we have discussed in the previous post, that how clock skew is going to affect hold violation. So if you remember, I have mentioned that if you will increase the clock skew, there is a probability that there will be the hold violation in your circuit. So now in this lecture, we will discuss about the setup violation, that how the clock skew is going to affect your setup violation. Same diagram, almost same waveform we will use, but we will just make little bit changes. So maybe this session will be little bit fast. Same circuit. Now this is a clock S, source clock. Clock 1, and it is a delayed just because of the buffer. This is a setup and hold time, and as we already discussed about the setup and hold time. Setup and hold time is with respect to the flip-flop. These are not with respect to the any clock. So these setup and hold time is not the property of the clock, it's a property of the flip-flop. So the requirement of the flip-flop is the data should be stable for a certain time before the clock edge, and that is a setup time. And similarly, data should be stable after the clock edge, and that is a hold time. So like here, D1, it is not changing within the setup and hold time, and we are applying D1 here. So with this positive clock, positive clock S, there is a CLK to Q delay, and after that we will get Q1 output. Now this Q1 output is going to travel to T2, and this is like, there will be some delay, whether it's an interconnect delay or there is a combinational delay, and with this there will be a delay, and I'm just saying that this is the TDP, that's the NAT or the gate delay. Now we are talking about the CLK2. So here you will see the difference. In the previous post, we started with the skew equals to 0, but here we are saying that in your design there is already a skew, and in that case what is going to happen. So I just started here. This is the first edge of the clock, second, third and the fourth, and from this edge you can see that this data is going to capture at this particular edge. So after the CLK to Q delay, you will get Q2 output. This particular data, the D1, it's transferred here, and this is capturing the second edge. And this difference, as we already know, that this is a clock skew. So right now our starting point is that there is already a clock skew, and in that case there is a no setup and hold violation. So this is your starting point. Now let's check what is happening if we will move the clock pulse. So now we will not increase the skew, we will decrease the skew. So now here we just decrease the skew. Now what is going to happen? From this positive edge, there is a delay, and then you will get the output Q2. So you can see that now the output is shifting toward your left hand side. So as you decrease the skew, your output is moving toward the left hand side. That means it becomes faster. So if you will increase the skew, it becomes slow, the output becomes slow. So slow in the sense, you want to get the output of the 4 seconds, let us suppose t equals to 4 seconds, and you are getting the output in the 4 equals to 5 seconds. So that is a slow. But if you will decrease the skew, then you can see that from the 5 to 4, it is decreasing. That means your system is getting faster. Now we again shifted toward the left hand side. That means now if you will see that there is no skew, the skew is 0. So I just took the example of skew equals to 0. Now you decrease the skew. From this point you are decreasing, and you are saying that this is a skew equals to 0. From this point you can see that from this edge, so now this is very nearer to the this transition of the T2 data. So here you can see that you are at the edge of the setup violation. So what is the setup time? The setup time say that before the clock edge, data should be stable, and you can see that it is not stable here, or it's just changing here. So in this case, what is going on? That you are getting the setup violation. Now from here, you will get CLK to Q delay, and your data is shifted again in the left hand side. Yeah, so your data is shifted in the left hand side. I can just summarize this thing that the behavior of the skew with respect to the hold violation and the behavior of the skew with respect to the setup violation is the reverse. In the hold violation, if you increase the skew, there is a probability that there will be a hold violation in your circuit. In the reverse, if you will decrease the skew, then there is a probability that there is a setup violation. That is the one thing. Another thing is, if you are increasing your skew, your system becomes slower, your circuit becomes slower, and if you will decrease the skew, your system, your circuit become faster. From the skew point of view, that how it is related to the setup and the hold time, I think you are clear. But now another question came into your mind, that in one case the skew is good, in one case skew is bad. So for the circuit point of view, you can say that okay, whether my circuit should have skew or whether my circuit should not have skew. So you become confused, because there is a advantage also and there is a disadvantage also. Okay, so this thing we will discuss in the next lecture, that whether we should have the skew in our circuit, or if there is a hold violation, whether we should decrease the skew to close the hold violation, or if we have the setup, whether we should increase the skew for fixing the setup violation, whether we should increase the skew. So that is that will be a very interesting topic, and I will also explain in that lecture that whether we should use this technique for the setup and hold violation fixes or not, and if we wants to if we are using this technique in the sense increasing and decreasing the clock skew, then what are the different precautions we have to take and what are the different advantage and disadvantage of this particular method. Thanks a lot.